Welcome back to my channel, friends. This is Sonia here, and today I am going to create a beautiful little planter for my kitchen window with this curd cup. So this is an empty plastic container which I got, and I've been asked many a times why I don't do decoupage on plastic. It's not that I have not done decoupage on plastic. I have done so many planters. I have done painting work, I have done decoupage work, and all those videos are there on my channel. I've been requested to do a video on decoupage box that I will be doing really soon. So today, let's do some nice decoupage and a nice glittery effect on this little pot. So here I am applying my white color acrylic paint, and I am going to cover up my complete pot. Now, one thing is, like, you must be thinking, this is already white. Why do I need to have a white color for my base, or why do I need to have a gesso? Now, usually with the plastics or tins, if you stick anything can come out really well. Like, it can come out super easy. So just to make sure that everything, whatever the work you do on your project, stays longer, so you need to prep up your base. Now here I'm using acrylic paint because I wanted to show you all that even with the acrylic paints also you can do the prepping up work really well. But of course, gesso is a far better option than acrylic paints. But here I am using acrylic paint, and with a sponge topper I'm going to cover up the complete container. And this is just to make sure that I can add some nice decoupage napkins and do some coloring work here and there. So now I will be using my heat gun in this complete video to make sure that I dry up everything well. And as it's a very thin plastic container, you will have to be really careful when you are drying this one. Now, especially when I'm working on my table, I try to make sure that it's really clean before doing my decoupage work. But some of the stains are so impossible to take out. So yeah, again, I just felt that I should use my heat gun to dry this up because it was not dried out completely. Now, this is one of the napkins which I had used for my earlier planter project, and I was asked that can we use it again. Yes, you can use one of the tissues on different varieties of project for sure. Like, beneath in the description box I'll share the link of two videos on which I've used the same decoupage napkin, but I have created a completely different project out of that. Now this napkin is absolutely beautiful, and I just have this much piece of this napkin. The rest I had already used on that previous project, so I just wanted to make sure that I use the maximum part of it, and trust me, I did not throw a single piece of the paper here. Now I'm just trying to make sure that I have small bits and bits pieces so that I can spread it very nicely on this pot. This pot is small, but it is going to be a little more demanding when it comes to decoupage napkin, so I will have to make sure that I cover up the most of the areas with this beautiful decoupage tissue. Now, if you don't have decoupage tissues, you can even do your decoupage work with your rice paper, with the pattern paper, with your DIY decoupage tissue. I've already done a video on that, how you can design your own decoupage tissue. Or you can even use a beautiful newspaper, what you get every day, and you can do your decoupage work with all of these. Now, here I am done with tearing off my pages, and now it's time to remove all the plies. But make sure that you remove all the plies off your napkin, and that is really important when you are sticking your decoupage napkins. Now, as I had used the water brush technique to remove the plies, remove the design, so the edges were wet, so I just run my heat gun very quickly, and now the plies are coming out so quickly. It is super easy. Once you use your heat gun on your napkins, your plies come out really easily. With a flat brush, I will be sticking my decoupage napkins, and the decoupage glue what I'm using here is my DIY decoupage glue. The video link is down below. And if you don't have your Mod Podge, you can always create your decoupage glue. It's super easy. You just need few of the supplies and you are done. Now here with the same flat brush, I'm sticking my napkin. If you are not very comfortable with this, you can use your plastic sheets to stick your napkins. But I have been doing this technique for like quite some time now, and I'm so comfortable with my flat brushes when it comes to sticking my decoupage napkins. If you are a beginner, you can also try out with the decoupage papers and the rice papers. They are going to be much more easier than your tissues because they are really thick and they really help in having no wrinkles at all. Now here I am just blending up my napkin here and there, and I just want to make sure that I cover up the maximum part. Like this is what I had told you, that I want to use this napkin. I want to make sure that I stick it up on the cup as much as areas as I can cover it up. Now the thing what I will be doing at the end is completely different, but here are a few of the tips. Like you can use any of your color paints, chalk paints, metallic paints, shimmer sprays or any kind of sprays and create beautiful color blending work here. I wanted to keep it little simple because it's for my kitchen window and I want to have very minimal bold colors there. So this floral is not going to pop out so well, and with the white it is going to look so subtle and so beautiful now. Now you can always do this technique. Like if you have a one big patch of paper, you can always trim down the decoupage napkins and then stick it here and there, and your maximum areas will be covered. Now this is a brush which I always use to stick my napkins. This is just to make sure that I press it really well, because with the brush on with which I apply my decoupage glue, it's really difficult to use that for sticking it up. So I just do a little press with that and then I use my flat brush. Now beneath the pot I'm going to stick all these excessive decoupage papers, because this container is really so thin that I don't want to use my sandpaper or my filer on this. Now again I will be using my heat gun and I'll make sure that I dry this up really well, but as it's a very thin plastic container, I will be doing the drying step in 2 or 3 times. With a scissor, I'm doing a good hole so that I can have my clay in this, my mud in that, and then I can have my plant. Now on the empty areas, I'm going to do my stamping work. Now here is a permanent ink pad which I will be using. You can use the dye-based ink pads also, but they are going to smudge. If you like that look and feel, you can of course go with that. But here I did not want it to do any color smudging work, so I am using my permanent ink pad and I'm using my script stamp for this. Now here is the fun part, and I just thought of doing the crystal decoupage on this, and the crystal decoupage is nothing but just adding some more glitter to your project. Now what kind of glitter do you need? So in the market there are varieties of glitters which is available. So what you need to do is you just need to add this to your liquid adhesive, but mostly what I do is I try this with my varnish and I spread it really well. Now why did I choose to have orange color glitter? Now as you see that my pot, the base color what I had done was plain white, and I just wanted to have a little shiny effect with some colors added to it, and this orange color glitter was really blending well with my project. Now in the first coat I have done it with the glitter, on the second coat I am just going to have my clear decoupage varnish, and this is going to make sure that this has been sealed really well and this lasts long. Now this was a very simple but a very nice video where you can learn all about the basic tips and tricks of the decoupage. I really hope that you all like this video. I am always very happy to help you guys with any of your queries. If you guys have any queries, please do comment below. I will be more than happy to help you all. Yes, of course, I'm sharing a few more pictures at the end of this pot so that you can have a closer look. And if you want me to make such more videos, please do mention the comment video and I will be more than happy to do that. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Plus do not forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye bye.